May 2023 as Asian American, Native Hawaiian, and Pacific Islander Heritage Month. To begin the presentation, I'd like to introduce Reza Liu, city employee, as well as a important HAPI representative. Welcome. Thank you for being here. I didn't know you were a model as well. This is great.
Hello, hello.
You do it all.
Yeah, I'm going to stand up if that's okay with everyone.
Please.
Hi, my name is Reza Liu. Thank you, Mayor Wheeler and Council, city employees, and everyone joining us here and online. My name is Reza Liu. I'm representing the HAPA Asian American Pacific Islander Group, also known as HAPI in the city, and we are in partnership and in solidarity with FACE, the Filipino American City Employee Resource Group. Even though we're here celebrating our heritage, I wanted to take time to spread awareness and to spread awareness that the acts of violence and hatred towards the API community continues to occur. We need to show each other support and kindness every day in our lives. We must continue to support each other. We acknowledge this unfortunate reality, but I want to take today to focus on our joy and beauty in our community. We are pleased to bring breaking and Samoan performances from the Portland metropolitan area's API communities to celebrate our cultures that contribute so much to our region. May have the breaking performers' new birth crew come up to the stage.
Yay.
And Kevin will say a few words.
Hi, y'all. I'm Kevin Lay, representing the New Birth Crew. I'm here alongside Serge Vella and Andy Manavong. It's an honor for us to be able to come here and share this beautiful gift of breaking and hip hop with y'all. We participate in our scene and community, as well as competitively all over the world. Breaking will be introduced in the 2024 Paris Olympic Games. So it's starting to gain a little more popularity, and we're really excited to show you the art form of how we do it in Portland. So we're very grateful to be here. As an Asian American myself, the son of two Vietnamese immigrants, it's just a huge honor to be able to share this and continue on this journey.
Thank you, and we do encourage sharing, you know, during the performance. The sound, can we start the audio, please?
Thank you.
have the honor of introducing the next performance, Talunuga by Kanisa Pe'ata. Talunuga is a traditional Samoan dance that is considered to be the climax to all fia-fia. The word Talunuga stems from the last stage of construction for a traditional fale house in Samoa. When the topmost part of Talunuga is placed and secured, it signifies that the fale is complete. The term in Samoan symbolizes the conclusion of the monumental task and the beautifying final touches. Our performer represents the dignity and honor of herself, her villages, her families, and ultimately the beautiful island of Samoa. Please join me in welcoming Kanisa Pe'ata. Is she here? She's almost here, guys. maybe a little few minutes too. Maybe I can also invite everyone after the performances. We do have food in the South Atrium provided by local caterers around the Portland area. And we...
Stalling.
Our keep stalling. We have white elephant. We have white elephant. It is a Lao Street food cart in Northwest Portland, and we also have Filipino food from Ian's Tasty Pandesal. So I hope to see everyone after the event, and we can talk and have conversations and eat. There is. Oh yeah, you want to read the proclamation? Yeah.
Why don't we do that?
Okay.
Yeah, and let's. Why don't we start with council comments, and we'll help you as Commissioner Gonzalez just said, tap dance, and then if she's not here, then we'll go to the proclamation. So we'll sequence.
We can bounce around stuff.
Yeah, Commissioner Mapps, why don't you go ahead?
Perfect. Thank you,
Mr. Mayor, colleagues. First, Reese, I want to thank you for being our MC today. I want to thank the artists who performed for us. That was a truly great way to kick off this very important moment. And I have a couple of words I want to share with the people in this room. I am delighted to join this council in proclaiming May 2023 to be Asian American, Native Hawaiian, and Pacific Islander Heritage Month. Now, of course, during this month, we come together to recognize the history, achievements, and unmet needs of Asian Americans, Native Hawaiians, and Pacific Islanders. Now, people of Asian ancestry have been here in Oregon since the 1850s. Our Asian ancestors worked mines in eastern Oregon. They built the railroads. They were farmers and fishermen. They built the Oregon that we inherited and love today. Now, despite the contributions Asian Americans have made to our community, our Asian American neighbors have endured a long history of discrimination. For example, the Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882 banned Chinese immigration to the United States. And of course, during World War II, in our own city, Portlanders of Japanese descent were rounded up and imprisoned at the Portland Expo Center before being shipped off to internment camps. And even today, Asian American communities endure harassment and violence. While racism may have been part of this city's past, racism must not be part of our community's future. That's why today this council stands with Asian American and our Pacific Islander neighbors in condemning and working to end acts of violence against the Asian American community. And there are other challenges which we must overcome too. The American dream remains out of reach for far too many Asian American families. That's why I want to thank our community partners who support Portland's API community, especially folks like Apano and ERCO and the Asian Family Center. the Chinese Consolidated Benevolent Association, the Vietnamese Community of Oregon, the Japanese American Society, and the Philippine American Chamber of Commerce. Thank you for the work you do. You represent Portland at our best. Colleagues, for these reasons and more, I am proud to join you in declaring May 2023 to be Asian American, Native Hawaiian, and Pacific Islander Heritage Month here in Portland, Oregon. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Rubio.
Thank you, Mayor. And I just want to thank you, Risa, for your wonderful energy that you're bringing into council today. And the new birth crew, that was amazing. You brought the energy up in the room. We all needed that today. So thank you. Thank you. We'll be writing on that for the rest of the week. And I look forward to seeing all the other performances. I also just want to acknowledge what you had said, you know, that over the last few years have been exceptionally hard for the AAPI community with the attacks and everything going on. And this increase in violence is unacceptable in our city and everywhere, and not what we should stand for in our city at all. And that's why today is important. That's why community organizations are important, employee organizations like HOPI, and artists, businesses, educators from the AAPI communities are such valuable contributors to the history and richness of the city. And our city owes you for the countless economic and social contributions. And so today is an important tribute to that. It's also a call to action and accountability for us to all walk our talk. So it's not just one day a year that we're talking about these things, but we're lifting up and supporting AAPI leadership. We're electing leaders to office. We are putting in appointing them and hiring them in leadership positions. We are growing youth into sectors that need more representation, and that we're supporting businesses and artists. So, and also that we're retaining our important AAPI workforce here at the city, because you are a reflection of who Portland is. So just thank you for your contributions, and I look forward to the rest of the program.
Thank you, Commissioner Rubio. Commissioner Gonzalez.
I just want to thank the performers, our many Asian American and employees in the city of Portland. I want to give a special call out to Nate Takara, Native Hawaiian, for his contribution for years in Portland Fire, as well as in the Street Service Coordination Center. When we talk about the discrete communities that make up this larger population, they came here for opportunity, they came here to build businesses and families and communities. They are a net very positive contributor to our community as a whole. So thank you for joining us and the broader community in Portland. Thank you for celebrating today with us. And I'll leave it at that.
Very good. Commissioner Ryan. Yeah.
Thank you, Mayor. Thanks for bringing this forward. I just want to thank you, Rui Salu, and your colleagues for, and from HAPI. Is it HAPI? H-A-P-I, right?
HAPI.
Yeah. Sorry. Mostly, I just want to get back to the performances. This feels like this unnecessary halftime of us giving these little proclamations while we were all really focused on the performances. So I'm glad we're winging it. Would you say we're tap dancing, right, Commissioner Gonzalez? But really, your expressions of the joy that you mentioned were really obvious, so we can't wait to see the next performance to celebrate. And that's truly the word that I'm picking up on today, Asian Pacific Islander and Asian American and Pacific Islander heritage. I always like to reminisce about my own personal history. At the late 70s, a lot of refugees came to this city from Vietnam because we share the waters, the Pacific, and Roosevelt and I think Marshall were the two high schools that were targeted to receive all the refugees, and I was a student at Roosevelt High School. So suddenly we had 300 refugees from Vietnam and Laos, and it was really a profound experience because suddenly we had this one-third of our school basically changed. And there was a lot that went on with that, just being a leader on student council trying to include the new immigrants into our fabric of the student body. And I know one personal friend I met at that time was Mr. Lee Pocha at ERCO, and he got active on student council. So it was never surprising to me to watch him rise now as a leader and an elder in your community. I also have had the benefit of my brother marrying well, and he married a Hawaiian and Filipino, and so it was 40 years ago. So our family's been blessed with having hulas before we have meals and such. And So I think like a lot of families, we're multicultural as we evolve and how we have to continue to embrace that in our beloved community. Finally, I just want to make a couple comments about having the opportunity in this job to get to know more people from the Tongan community. After the devastation, the extreme weather to that island, it was an opportunity to dive in and get to know that community. It's a really vibrant community, and throughout Portland, especially, I know they, a lot of rugby matches are played out at Northgate Park. So you could see, I see that community like I never had before in the past. And also meeting with, especially in East Portland, small businesses, especially the smaller Chinese restaurants that have really, like all small businesses, have really struggled with the increases in crime and burglaries and vandalism to their businesses, and how we can see them and really be there for them in a culture that has a lot of pride and a lot of resilience, and having to break down some of the, I think, the barriers for them to also be a part of the restoration as we move forward as a beloved community. So I'm just really grateful that we take time today to celebrate the API community, and I look forward to the rest of these, the next performance. I think she's almost back. Yeah?
Okay. Reese, is Kenisa here yet? Yes. Okay, I'm going to defer my comments, and we'll hear from Kenisa.
Our performer is ready. Do we want to do the performance, then the proclamation?
Yes, please.
Perfect. Hello again, everyone. Join me in welcoming Kenisa Pe'ata and dancing a traditional Taluga. Audio, please. Turn up the audio, please. Thank you. Thank you, Kanisa, for that beautiful performance. That wraps up our performance for today. I'd like to extend the invitation again to join us for a meal downstairs in the South Atrium. We have Grimes' Tribe, the local Hawaiian food vendor. White Elephant is a Laos street food. And Ian Pandesal, which is a Filipino restaurant.